You're watching UNICEF television. It wasn't just fancy footwork or fancy football boots or even no boots that got these Zimbabwean girls flying. And it wasn't just their song and dance routine or their passion for drama either. It was getting the message out to their peers about HIV/AIDS and not abstaining from what they love best, football. It all led to the Glenview Queens being picked for the international youth tournament, the Norway Cup. They might not have proper goalposts, but it hasn't stopped them scoring goals for their country that's seen better times.
I feel very proud of myself to be the ambassador of Zimbabwe.
With the highest percentage of orphans in the world, 13-year-old Amiga, like many of her teammates, is an orphan too, and knows all too well how that came about.
My mother died of HIV AIDS. She suffered, and she began to die, and she passed away. As a youth, I would teach other, and someone would teach me about HIV and AIDS, rather than begging a grown-up men or women say, tell us about AIDS, tell us about, we now know about AIDS and I should teach my peers.
And Omega, what do you think people in Europe know about Zimbabwe?
They say Zimbabwe is a poor, very poor country, but I want to tell them that Zimbabwe is rich in everything, mineral, gold, everything, even fertile soil. It is rich.
So why do you think people are struggling with food?
Lack of thinking. Lack of rank of thinking.
No lack of thinking here. Amiga says the sky's the limit for her and Zimbabwe in the future. And it's the love of the beautiful game and hard work that she says has given her and her friends the winning spirit. This is Sarah Crowe in Harare, Zimbabwe for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.